I wasn't going to speak on this point, but since it was just raised by Senator Bonasek, you know, it's this utopian philosophy of various policies until you're the individuals who are in control of the House. The minority is now wanting equal resources. If you look at the numbers from last year, the total final numbers for the amount spent on the Democrat side of the aisle, the amount spent on the Republican side of the aisle, despite their philosophical desire for equality, 71% of the resources went to the Democrats in this House, 29% went to Republicans. The Democrats in the House went over their budget by 10 to 14 million. The Republicans went under their budget by several million. So it's one thing talking philosophy and trying to lecture one side or the other side, but if you look at the facts, what is the real reality behind what's being argued for and what was really done? But on the lieutenant governor issue, which I think is a very important issue, there's been some suggestion by Senator Gennaris that we are somehow interpreting the Constitution by putting it in the bill, in the rules. All that's being done, if you look at the Constitution, the phrase from the Constitution is taken from the Constitution and put in the rules. There's no changes. It's taken from the Constitution and put in the rules. No interpretation of anything. And when you indicate that this is some way doing something wrong, just listen to the rules here. The Constitution, I mean. The Constitution says this: a majority of each House shall constitute a quorum, etc. Each House shall determine the rules and be judge of elections and qualifications, and shall choose its own officers. And the Senate shall choose a temporary president, and the Assembly chooses a speaker. The Senate. I don't think anybody in here truly believes that the lieutenant governor is a member of the Senate. Lieutenant governor does not run for the Senate. He runs, and he's not even here tonight. The lieutenant governor is a presiding officer. That's all he does. So all that's being done is the Constitution phrase is put right in the rules to make it very clear that this body, including Democrats and Republicans, choose who their leader is going to be, not someone who ran with the executive and is a member of the executive branch. I'll answer a question as soon as I get done with this last point. There's been a lot of argument about another section of the Constitution on what a casting vote is. Whatever a casting vote is, and you can have one interpretation from somebody who wrote something in 1902 or someone from the New York Times or whatever, the fact of the matter is it's irrelevant what's meant by a casting vote. That's a general concept. The specific section of the Constitution says the Senate shall choose. So as to the choice of a temporary president, it's very clear. The specific clause overrides some possible different interpretations by pundits and treatise writers and so forth as to what a casting vote is.